So, I went to switch my party around so I could get experience on, Mog and Locke and, a little bit on Setzer, despite him not having very good weapons. I don't know why I don't have the dice, but, I got the Celestriad! Jesus Christ. that doesn't go with the Soul of Thamaza just because I really, really need the Miracle Shoes, but. Whoops. Where are they? Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. Today we're finally going to assault Kefka's tower. The first time. Alright, I want to unequip everyone. Alright, Kefka's tower is on the southern continent, the former empire. Three parties I need. I have every single possible character. Do we necessarily need to destroy them, though? I mean, is it impossible to just put them back into their balance? That's a fair point. Alright, so one mage per party. Let's put. Locke definitely has to go with Celeste. I'm gonna put Mog with Realm, just so I have a Dragoon there. Edgar is the other, is a miscellaneous physical character. Cyan and Shadow and Saven are fighters. Sort of, they're physical DPS. Now that leaves me. Okay. Strago is a miscellaneous mage. This seems to be the weakest magical party, so I'm gonna put Strago there. Because Saven and Mog don't have a lot of magic. Celeste, Locke, and Shadow have tons between them. As do Terra, Edgar, and Cyan. I'm not using Gao. I think I'm going to bring Setzer with my highest average level party, just so that he can level up and be helpful. I'm gonna bring Umaro just because I never used him and he doesn't seem that complex to use. Unlike Gogo. Alright. I believe Party 2 is gonna fight the dragons, which may wind up being an issue. It shouldn't be one. Oh, I need to equip. Before I do anything, teleport stone, everyone. Okay, so obviously optimize. Well, I need the enhancer for Terra. You're gonna keep your Death Tarot. It's known as Antetsuken. You can take the... Oh, wow. Yeah, you're fine with this, Antetsuken. Alright, Terra... You're just gonna get Hermes Sandals and the Soul of Themaza. Edgar, you're going to get... No, not Dragoon Boots, that's for Mog. You go ahead and take... The Alarm Earring... How's your defense? 202... Do I have just a cast shell on the user? You can go ahead and take the guard bracelet. Your haste isn't that necessary. Cyan, you have the Genji glove and master scroll. Yeah, that's fine. And Setzer, you get Hermes because of your low level, you need the miracle shoes. And Hajime's Jitte. Or Heiji's Jitte. Hajime is something completely different. Party 2. Celeste, I'm gonna see how you do with the Gladius. I might switch you over to the Ultima Weapon. That's about right. Oh, right. Umaro only gets... excuse me. Relics. I think he gets, the Blizzard Orb. Equip on a Yeti and see what happens. And he can also wear the Berserker Ring. So he absorbs both fire and ice, meaning non-elemental and thunder are the only elements he has to fear. I'm curious. He does have equipment, technically, a bone club and a snow scarf. Relics. So you... I think I'm going to give you the Celestrion, but only Hermes Sandals, because you have decent defenses. You take... do I want to give you the Brigand's Glove? I'm going to give you the Thief's Bracer and Hermes Sandals. Actually, no, your defenses suck. You get Miracle Shoes. And Shadow. I'm gonna go ahead and give you the Sniper Eye. And Sandals. And Party 3. Relics. Realm is going to take... the gold hairpin and miracle shoes. Mog is just going to take the dragoon relics. Saban also gets a Genji glove. And... yeah, you go ahead and take Miracle Shoes. Strago, you get a gold hairpin. You're tough. I'm thinking the Zephyr Cloak. Ooh. Or the hero. Yeah, I'm gonna give you the hero's rank because you can shank people, right? Yeah. Alright. Let's focus on party one for now. Seems more specifically like the ruin of Vector, Great Behemoth? The ruin of Vector and, oh, I didn't get rested. The Flying Continent. Haymaker. Did I just get decked in the face by a behemoth? Oh, right. Espers. Terra, you have need of... Quick! Edgar, you have need of... Phoenix. Cyan, you have need of... Ultima, you have need of everything. You take... Well, you have Bismarck. It's Velgarmonda that you need. Dark forces, like we were fighting in the arena. And they inflict instant death. Which isn't really an issue as much as it is an annoyance. Okay, you need to get ethered. Fixed dice, that's what I was thinking of for Setzer. Completely random damage, which apparently is ridiculous with the Master Scroll. Oh no, it can hit everyone! Instant death is not fun, by the way. Just in case anyone thought that it was fun game design, it's not. Just PSA. Unless there's a way to do it that doesn't involve farming incredibly rare accessories that I'm not even sure are farmable. Behemoth, Marlboro. What am I doing? You know, I shouldn't be using Guild Toss as freely as I am when I need to save up for Excalibur. Alright, party two. Primeval Dragon and Great Marlboro. Okay, who is healing it? More Great Marlboros. Teleport Stones. Right. Espers. Jeez. Oh, you don't have any of Kotobal Claws. Velagramanda would be good for you, but instead take Lakshmi. Morrow can't even. Ooh, another Minerva boost Bustier. Need to throw that onto Terra. Off this way? No? Oh, that's an out from a door. A pinwheel shuriken. Huh. Demon Knight and Yojimbo. Isn't Yojimbo a summon in 10 or something? Pretty sure it wasn't Samurai who followed Hammurabi's code. Oh, that's a dragon. Why am I even bothering to physically run? Oh no, that's the Ultima Buster. I think this is worth throwing a pinwheel at. Stole a blood sword. Faraga. Let's go ahead and just throw up a Kiraga just in case. I'm not sure of everyone's max HP. Tsunami. Got him. No immediate reward? Oh! Is it an Esper? So my reward is a tent point and a save point. I think Final Fantasy V did that in that game's final dungeon too. Make you fight a boss to earn your save points. Movers! Oh, those, that's where those things came from in 7. They're annoying enough to not fight, but... Oh god. Return of the Pipe Mazes. Literal garbage. Hit him with Thundara. Oh. Oh, that's what the Blizzard Orb does. I think that's what I thought to upgrade to Miracle Shoes. Okay. Dual armor and Fortis. Okay, I need to change magic. There we go. A force shield? For a good Ultima. Maybe I should forego the Miracle Shoes and just combine the ribbon. Well, there's some more stuff over here that I want to explore, but just go for Soul of Thamaza and Celestrion. Just because of the possibilities of pretty much infinitely dual casting Ultima. Okay. Here's a dragon. One of the two. Oh! No, that's Daedalus and Ahriman. Level 5 death. Okay, so let's go double holy. Or just holy. Ultima. Shadow can throw a shuriken at Ahriman, because I remember it being weak to throw in. No, it's just, this is a random encounter, duh. I just recall Ahriman being weak to throw in 4. Fall before... fighting the Gold Dragon. What is with these dinosaur dragons? I guess the implication is supposed to be that dragons came from dinosaurs? Free Ultima. Obtained crystal orb. One dragon remaining. What's a crystal orb do? Boosts maximum MP by 50%, so that's not actually a Yeti item. Alright. Let's see what Party 3 has to do. Red Cap. Oh, maybe I should have given it. Oh no. Right, Behemoth, or Malboro's like ice. And holy, apparently. Great. It's hard to tell what's a side path. Innocent. Yeah, I doubt it. Oops, that was supposed to be all targeting. Nutkin soup. Plus one to speed, but worse in every other way. Why do they even give you the different suits if the behemoth suit is just so much better than all of them? Gauntlet. It's a movie I haven't seen. Hoping the dragon stand will earn me the 500 grand I need. I think it will at this point. Yeah, it's not worth fighting back attacks. Can I not run away? That's dumb. In a way, I'm kind of glad I'm almost done. Ooh, another Hero's Ring. That's awesome for a Celeste and kind of Terra. Like, I'm always afraid of games overstaying their welcome, because then I stop liking them. Like, I just remember, oh, that outstayed its welcome. Like, even 7 kinda got that way. Although, a lot of my negativity was towards the fact that, well, one, they lacked a fairly significant plot detail about the main villain behind 2 layers of side questing. And 2, the ruby weapon sucks. Like, they never add anything good to the international editions of the Final Fantasy games. When I do 10, I'm not fighting the freaking... I don't need a 10. I'm not fighting the Dark Aeons or Penance. Oh, hello. This was a sudden boss, so you're getting nuked. Magitech Barrier. It's not Reflect. Hopefully. Doesn't matter. No reward. Now we're in already. I do want to at least get through to the point where I'm just where next time we can start the Dragon's Den. Maybe I should leave the Dragon's Den for actual post-game? I don't know. Why is this an Evangelion situation where you cannot run away? Wait, no, it's must not run away. Crap. Excuse me? Oh, Megalixir. I think think I made that accessible? Rainbow Brush. That's pretty bad. Why does it say there are four of them? They're stacked on top of each other. This is so dumb. Like, hilarious, but dumb. I guess that's all I can do out here, but I do have this. Oh! I thought that party 2 was gonna fight both of them. Okay. Doing this without Turaga?
Gonna be interesting.
The Skull Dragon. Probably weak to Holy. So really, I am in a very good situation for this. There we go. I don't even need to use Ultima. I'm not scared of your DPS race, even if it starts at 18 for some reason. Doom. Obtained Muscle Belt. All 8 dragons have been defeated. The Eightfold Seal is broken! The seal has been broken. Obtained Crusader Magicite. There's a small stone tablet on the ground. On its face is a short inscription. The seal is broken, and I am free. You who defeated the Legendary 8, I shall await you at the Dragon's War. Which means... next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy VI Advance, we're taking on the post-game dungeon before actually fighting Kefka. See you guys then!